Yeah, yeah, definitely.
To the NIV version, by the way, just in case you're wondering. So
and some people brought a blind man.
Who's going blind?
They.
Jesus still does miracles today.
Hi guys!
Hi guys! How has your week been? I hope it has been good. Today we are doing
Mark 8!
Woo!
Okay, let's start.
Let's start.
Verse 1. Follow in your Bibles.
Yeah, yeah, definitely.
If you don't know what that is, Google it.
This is the NIV version, by the way, just in case you're wondering. Yeah.
You ready?
I'm ready. Let's go.
Verse 1. During those days, another large crowd gathered. Since they had nothing to eat, Jesus called his disciples to him and said, I have compassion for these people. They have been with me 3 days and have nothing to eat. If I send them home hungry, if I send them home hungry, they will collapse on the way, and some of them have come a long distance. His disciples answered, but where in this remote place can anyone get enough bread to feed them? How many loaves do you have? Jesus said.
Seven, they replied.
He told the crowd to sit down on the ground. When he had taken the 7 loaves and given thanks, he broke them and gave them to his disciples to distribute to the people, and they did so. They had a few small fish as well. He gave thanks for them also and told his disciples to distribute them. The people ate and were satisfied. Afterwards, the disciples picked up 7 basketfuls of broken pieces that were left over. About 4,000 were present. After he had sent them away, he got into a boat with his disciples and went to the region of, yes, that place. The Pharisees came and began to question Jesus to test him. They asked him for a sign from heaven. He sighed deeply and said, why does this generation ask for a sign?
Why does this generation ask for a sign?
Truly I tell you, no sign will be given to it. Then he left them, got back into the boat, and crossed to the other side.
Jesus still does miracles today.
Part 2. Verse 14. Then the disciples had forgotten to bring bread, except for 1 loaf they had with them in the boat. Be careful, Jesus warned them. Watch out for the yeast of the Pharisees and that of Herod. They discussed this with one another and said, is it because we have no bread? Aware of their discussion, Jesus asked, why are you talking about having no bread? Do you still not see and understand? Are your hearts hardened? Do you have eyes but fail to see, and ears but fail to hear? And don't you remember when I broke the 5 loaves for the 5,000, how many basketful of pieces did you pick up?
12,
they replied. And when I broke the 7 loaves for the 4,000, how many basketful of pieces did you pick up?
7,
they answered. He said to them, do you still not understand?
The disciples forgot what Jesus had just done, and he was a miracle worker. It seemed they were still blinded to who Jesus really was. Let's carry on with the chapter.
Part 3. Verse 22. They came to that place, and some people brought a blind man. I'm just going blind. There. And begged Jesus to touch him. He took the blind man by the hand and led him outside of the village. When he had spat on the man's eyes and put his hands on him, Jesus said,
do you see anything?
He looked up and said, I see people, they look like trees walking around. Once more, Jesus put his hands on the man's eyes. Then his eyes were open. His sight was restored and he saw everything clearly.
Jesus sent him home, saying, "Don't even go into the village."
Jesus still does miracles today.
Part
4. Verse 27. Jesus and his disciples went on to the villages around
that place.
On the way, he asked them, "Who do people say I am?" They replied, "Some say John the Baptist, others say Elijah, and still others, one of the prophets. "But what about you?" he asked. "Who do you say I am?" Peter answered, "You are the Messiah." Jesus warned them not to tell anyone about him.
So here, Jesus is walking with his disciples, and his disciples, he's asking, "Who do you say that I am?" Because he's just done these miracles. Do they see him as just a prophet, or do they see him as the actual Messiah? And it's really important because Peter says, "I see you as the Messiah," which means I see you as the miracle worker. I see you as the Savior.
Part 5. Verse 31. He then began to teach them that the Son of Man must suffer many things and be rejected by the elders, the chief priests and the teachers of the law, and that he must be killed and after 3 days rise again. He spoke plainly about this, and Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. But when Jesus turned and looked at his disciples, he rebuked Peter. "Get behind him, Satan," he said. "Do you not have in mind the concerns of God, but merely humans' concerns?"
You see, here Jesus was talking about the fact that he was about to be crucified. And even though Peter knew he was the Christ, he still didn't really believe what Jesus was saying. Let's carry on.
Go. The way of the cross. Then he called the crowd to him along with his disciples and said, "Whoever wants to be my disciple must deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. For whoever wants to save their life for me and for the gospel will save it. What good is for someone to gain the whole world yet forfeit the soul? Or what can anyone give in exchange for their soul? If anyone is ashamed of me and my words is the adulterous and sinful generation, the Son of Man will be ashamed of them, and he comes in his Father's glory and with the holy angels."
You see, what he's saying is that he's a miracle worker. We need to believe in him as the Messiah. And then also, number 3, take up our cross and follow him daily. Which doesn't just mean taking up a cross and saying, "Oh, I believe in Jesus." It means becoming a disciple like Peter did and following him wherever he goes, even to the ends of the earth.
So guys, that was Mark 8. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and we'll see you soon.
Bye!